Hi, welcome to Harmony with Su-Lynn, and in this tutorial we're going to look at rigging the hair. And this is following on from rigging the character head, where we've covered rigging the eyes and the mouth. But in this tutorial we're going to look at weighted deformers, which is slightly different. When you're designing a character, one of the things that can make all the difference is the hair. What we can do is have one character but just experiment with loads of different hairstyles. So here we go. And here you can also change the different colors, and it can make a real difference to the look of the character. So before we start, let's take a look at some of the rig. And here we can see it in the node view. If I select on one of the pieces I've made, I've already added a deformer, and we can see that the deformer is placed in a way which can allow us to animate any movement from a head turn to perhaps a change of expression or creating anticipation. To begin with, you're going to have to create the assets and to separate out your hair into at least 2 to 3 pieces. It may be easier for you to design your hair as one piece and then cut and paste them into separate drawings. So here I have 3 pieces. One is for the main piece of hair in the front, and then I have 2 side pieces to the left and then to the right. So go ahead and design your assets, and then we'll start to rig. So let's begin by putting in a peg on all our pieces of hair, and then also adding the rotation points. Once we've added the rotation points, we can start to rig. What we can see is line art that is cutting some of the color art in areas that we may want to look continuous in terms of the color art. So for this, we can try using an auto patch. So we can get the auto patch node from the node library, or we can look for the node library by hitting return and finding auto patch. So if we just put it in AU, it should come up. And then we want to attach the auto patch by taking a connector from under the piece that you want to auto patch and then connecting it to the auto patch. Remember that the way you attach your auto patch is not in the main connector, it's a separate connector that you pull from underneath the piece. And then it's always to auto patch to above the top of the hierarchy. And once we do that, we can see it has created this continuous color art, which is what we're looking for. Now, one thing you might want to do is to add some highlight. And I'm going to just demonstrate with some I've made earlier in just a very, very simple way. And here I've put in a highlight, and I'm going to now rig it with a deformer. So I'm just going to select my peg, go to the deformer tool, and then just check that I have envelope deformer on, and then go ahead and put the rig in. Just something to remember is that if you have something that's quite a complex design, such as this area I have on the fringe, you don't have to have the deformer follow identical to the line. It can be quite loose. Let's check that out and see how that's working with our detail on the highlight. So if I move and test my deformer, oops, what I can see here is I've broken the rig. So that's looking a little bit crunchy there. A little bit messy as I test that in terms of how I might want to animate. And we can see it's all very, very crunchy. So how do we fix that? So with this method, you will have to create the highlight or tone as a separate drawing. So here's one I made earlier. I'm just going to enable. So here is my highlight, which is on a separate drawing. Now, instead of having it as one piece, which is what I did in my demonstration, I have it as 2 separate drawings, one for the main hairpiece and one for the highlight. Now, what we need to do is to get, first of all, a cutter to cut the highlight so it sits within the hair. So I'm going to select on the highlight. First of all, add a peg, as always, and then add the rotation point. And then let's select the node so that the cutter attaches for us straight away. So I've called up my node library and then just putting up CU for cutter, and then here we have it. So once I have my cutter attached, I now need a color art to be able to cut it. So for this, I don't want it to come attached to the head node. So I'm going to deselect somewhere off the working area and then again call up my node library and then put in CO, first two letters, and just find color art. Now with the color art, first of all, you need to connect it from the bottom of the node to the color art, and then from the color art at the bottom to connect it to the port of the cutter that you want to use. And then what we need to do is to invert that. And now we have the highlight is cut by the hair piece. We can see that the line is slightly inconsistent. So what we need is a line art. And then with the line art, we can put that at the top of the hierarchy. But oops, again, what's happened is when we've done that, as you can see, if I disconnect that, we've got a nice continuous line here. As soon as I put the line art at the top, the line comes back. So that's easily fixable. So we just need to go to the auto patch, see where the connector is, and place that at the top. And then now we've got the best of both. So now we have a highlight and we have the hair. But if I put on my deformer and I start manipulating my hair, we can see that the highlight is not following along right now. So let's work out how we take care of that. And we do that by using, this is a new node, a new deformer, it's called the weighted deformer. So let's go ahead and again get the node library and then put in weighted deformer. Now the weighted deformer works in a slightly different way. It appears to have one port at the top. But what we need to do is to take a connector from under the deformer that we've placed on the hairpiece and almost show it to the node. And when we do that, it reveals another port. It's magic. And here we go. We have it on the left-hand side of the port, and that's where we want it connected. Now, what we now need to do is to connect the bottom from the bottom of the weighted deformer to the hairpiece and also to the highlight that we've made. So we can drag another connector from under the weighted deformer to the top of the hairpiece. And there we go. Now let's just adjust that so it's not so cramped over here. So what we see is we have the hair, one hairpiece, one highlight, and the highlight's been cut by the hair. And now we've added the weighted deformer, which attaches both the hair and the highlight together. And overall, we have one deformer. So now let's go ahead and check that. And if we adjust that and move the deformer as if we were going to animate something, there we can see the highlight is moving together with the main piece of hair beautifully and not breaking the deformer. So that's great. Added to that, I'm just going to show you a really nice way of moving multiple points on your deformer. So for instance, if we hold down shift and then just select the fringe area of my character's hair and then go up here to show manipulator over here, it gives us a little bounding box. And now if we just adjust and move all that, and then we can also rotate, we can see we can start to create quite nice movement and move all pieces together. So it's just really efficient. And there we have rigging the hair.